What's up, geeks, and welcome to the channel. In the last video of this series, we introduced the backtracking algorithm, and as we mentioned, grasping this technique takes time and practice. Therefore, in today's video, we are going to solve backtracking problems while attempting to explain new mathematical concepts such as permutations and combinations. Now, before we dive in the problem statement and its implementation, I am going to explain the difference very briefly between permutations and combinations. Okay, you should know that the order of the elements matters in a permutation and doesn't in a combination. So, if we have these three elements and we want to permute them, then we'll have this set of six arrays as answer because the order does matter, meaning this array is different than this one and different than all the others. Whereas, if we wanted to find a combination of three elements out of the given three, then we'll only have a single result set because all these arrays are considered equal in a combination as order does not matter. Now, each of the permutations and combinations can be split into two categories, where element repetition is allowed and where element repetition is not allowed. And usually during interviews, you will be asked to retrieve distinct results, i.e. where repetition is not allowed. You see, all their implementation is similar, but grasping the mathematical aspect of repetitions and asking about it is harder to do. Let me know in the comments below if you'd like a dedicated video explaining the difference between each category from a mathematical point of view. Okay, now onto the problems. Suppose we were given an array of distinct integers and we were asked to return all its possible permutations. This means that, 1, we are talking about permutation without repetition, so if we were given an array of 8 elements as input and we wanted to permute 3 out of the 8, then after choosing, say, number 4, we can't choose it again. So our first choice has 8 possibilities, and our next choice has 7 possibilities, then 6, 5, etc. And the total permutations are 8 times 7 times 6 equals 336. And 2, we want to permute n elements out of n, and not r out of n like the example we just saw, i.e. all the elements must be used. Now, if you recall our previous video and remember the backtracking template we defined, you may have an idea on how we are going to implement this problem. So, first we will need to define our recursive call and pass to it the candidates provided to us, the resulting permutations we are looking to return, and a temporary array to store the current path or permutation we are generating. A result is found as soon as the number of elements in our current path is equal to the number of elements in the candidate set, as this means that all the elements have been used and are part of the permutation currently being generated. If we're not there yet, we'll need to traverse all the candidates and apply the template, meaning we add the candidate in question to the current path, then call the same recursive method again to further explore this path, and finally, when this path's traversal ends, we remove that candidate or element. The last missing piece from our template is the candidate check that should go right there, and this one should check if that element is already present in the path we are traversing, and if it is, we skip it. Remember, we mentioned that no repetitions are allowed among the resulting elements, and that as soon as we pick an element, we aren't allowed to pick it again. By adding this condition, we are making sure that all these constraints are met, and that indeed, when the size of the path is equal to the candidate's given number, we have a solution. That's it! That is how you implement permutations with no repetition with the help of backtracking. Now, concerning combinations without repetitions, you may be given two integers, n and k, let's say. And you could be asked to return all possible combinations of k numbers chosen from the range 1 to n inclusive. You may recall this as the NCR notation in math, or given n choose r. So, if we were to choose 3 elements out of 4, then we will have 4 total combinations. Remember, order does not matter in combinations, making all the arrays to the right equivalent to the 4 to the left. Okay, so implementing this will be very similar to the permutations one, but instead of having an array of candidates, all we need are two integers, n and k. We will pass these integers down to our recursive call alongside the resulting combinations we will be generating and the current combination path we are traversing, similarly to what we did for the permutation. The for loop will start at 1 and end at n, just like the question says, and for now let's keep everything else the same. Let's apply the template as is. Let's even keep the breaking condition and the candidate's condition that make sure that no repetitions are allowed. Now, if we attempt to run this logic with n equals 4 and k equals 3, you will notice that this is the result set we will obtain. And if you look closely, you will notice that, yeah, okay, we do not have element repetition among a single result, but ordering is being taken into consideration even though it shouldn't matter. You see, we previously mentioned that ordering is not important in a combination, therefore the elements in red should not be present. These elements should be considered as duplicates and should not be part of our result set, as these elements represent the possible permutations of 3 out of 4 elements and not the combinations. So, the contains check here is not enough, as the path should not only not have duplicate elements, but it should also avoid iterating over that element more than once for a given combination. Therefore, what we need to do is keep track of the starting element of the combination we are currently generating, and it is this element that we will use as the initial element of our for loop. Meaning, if our current path starts at number 2, let's say, we do not want to start the iteration from 1 and attempt to add it to our result set, because 2, 1 is a duplicate of 1, 2, and this case was already handled when our combination started with 1. We want to move forward only and add number 3 to the result. To do that, to move forward, the only change we need to apply is to increment the starting number by 1 every time we invoke the recursive call. Everything else, everything stays the same, just like the template. And that's it. The link to the LeetCode problems we solved today can be found in the description below. Let me know your thoughts and suggestions for upcoming videos in the comments section. And that's it for today. I hope it was helpful. Thank you guys for watching. Take care, and I will see you in the next one.